popularity of chroming is this morning under a spotlight in the wake of the death of a Victorian teenager. A dozen teens have died from inhaling dangerous chemicals since 2009, while 18% of teens have tried inhalants. Let's bring in Professor Michael Farrell from the University of New South Wales. Professor, thanks so much for your time this morning. Are you concerned there's not enough education around the dangers of chroming? We know it's toxic, but can you explain how it works?
Yeah, so first of all, I think if we use the term aerosol inhalation, it's more descriptive because there's a fear that chroming is glamorising this behaviour. So the thing is, aerosol inhalation is anything in the household can be used. And it's the propellant in the aerosol that is the active thing. So that can be either butane or propane. And with teenagers, there's a tendency for them to experiment with this before they've been involved with any other drugs at all, alcohol or tobacco. But the actual popularity of this was highest in the 80s during the punk era with glue sniffing and aerosol inhalation. And it's been significantly lower. But the more recent thing is quite worrisome about this rise. And basically what happens when people spray directly into the back of their throat, they can get laryngeal spasm, or also it results in can result in the heart stopping or breathing stopping. And the message we need to be very clear about is that these are toxic substances and dangerous substances, and we need a clear message through parents and teachers and retailers to understand where there's any indication that people might be buying for that purpose, that they should not be sold.
And this is the thing. I mean, you're saying that its popularity has declined over time, but I guess, you know, that the parents of this young girl, this 13-year-old in Victoria, are determined to stamp it out altogether. So it is still happening.
Well, absolutely, because these are products that are available in every house in multiple forms. So they are very accessible. That's one of the things. And a lot of the time, these are actually people just experimenting. Mm. So the really important message is to be clear that it's volatile substance misuse, aerosol inhalation, and it actually can be fatal. The actual number of deaths is actually quite small, but I must extend my sympathy to this family and hope that they've got the support and privacy that's appropriate to this their terrible loss.
And I guess just quickly, Professor, obviously, you know, you mentioned these are household items. What can parents do to try and protect their kids?
Well, I mean, they have to be aware of the storage of these items, and if they were being used to intervene, it's really important. And that's the same. I mean, we saw a very active campaign in the 90s, which really suppressed the use of these. And there's, but they're universally available. Any aerosol can be used.
All right, Professor, thanks so much for your insight. Let's hope people heed the message. Thank you.